Lookup relation.
Lookup relation.
Lookup relation.
Many to many.
Many to many, what is that? Junction, right?
Junction
object.
Hierarchical.
Hierarchical relation. Hierarchical relation.
External lookup relation.
External lookup relation. Remember all these points, because in the interviews, people will ask definitely these questions. What type of relations, how many types of relations I can establish between the objects in Salesforce? The answer is master detail relation, lookup relation, junction object, hierarchical relation, external lookup relation. And also, the questions, what are all different questions they can ask here? If you want to write down. How many ways we can provide relations in Salesforce? How many ways we can provide relations in Salesforce? This is one question. And tell me the differences between master detail relation, master detail and lookup relation. Can anyone tell me what is the differences? What are all differences we have? Lookup relation and this one. Anyone tell me?
Master is will be having standard objects. And lookup relation, we have like standard and custom object.
See, master detail relation only on custom objects, not standard.
Yeah.
Just correct that point. Only on custom objects. Master detail relation we can provide on only on custom objects. Right. You can go ahead.
Yes. Which contains data, then
whether the object is contains the data. If it is contains the data, we cannot create the master detail relation. Lookup relation, if data is there or not, also we can create the relation. Correct? That's what you are telling. Correct.
Yes.
Next point.
Lookup relation will be like non-mandatory. It's an optional field.
Yes. Good.
Yeah. Master relation will be like mandatory.
Right. So how do you create many-to-many relation in Salesforce? Can anyone answer this question?
By creating junction object.
Yeah. So any object contains two master detail relations in it. So we can that one we can call it as many to many relation. Right. So there are different questions people will ask here. So hierarchical relation also, I didn't write the question, but everything is a one question here. Explain hierarchical relation. How do you establish hierarchical relation? What is the purpose of hierarchy? Right? Like this, we will get the questions. See, next thing, what we have to see, roles and profiles in Salesforce. Roles and profiles. What is role in Salesforce and what is profile in Salesforce? Very, very important concept. After fields, after fields, every topic is very, very important in your interviews and work related. Work calls. So you have to understand properly.
Sir, your voice is breaking between, sir.
No one will ask how to create applications.
No, sir.
All things people will not ask. That is the major concept. You want to understand, as admin, you know, sorry, what the users, right?
Yes,
so what is going to be? Role is nothing but.
Your voice is breaking. Now it's fine. Yes.
Now you are able to.
No.
Now it's fine, everyone?
Fine, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Right. So, what I was discussing, roles and profiles is very, very important in Salesforce. What role will decide? Role will decide hierarchy of your organization. Hierarchy. Or structure of your organization. That means, for whom I want to report. For example, in any of the company, if you take, so first, who will be there? CEO, right? Vice President, VP, or senior vice president, or vice president. Any of organization, if you take the basic hierarchy, I'm telling. The director, under director, who will work? Senior project manager. Under senior project manager, we have a project manager. Project manager. Under project manager, project leader. Under project leader, team lead, TL. Under team lead, who will be there? SSC, senior software engineer. Under senior software engineer, we have software engineers. Under software engineers, we have associate software engineer. Associate software engineers, AC. Associate software engineers. Everyone clear?
Yes. So, it comes under respectively.
Maybe if you join, you may join as a software engineer or senior software engineer based on your experience.
Okay.
Four plus years of experience if you are putting, so maybe they will offer senior software engineer position. If you are putting software 3+ years or 2+ years, 1+year, so below 4 years, they will give software engineer position. More than 5 years, 6 years, they will offer team lead. Don't take this much positions, okay? So don't target these positions. Putting as experience, okay? Don't target these things. Your target is these things. Again, you will not comes under ASC. You will not comes under ASC because it's pressure. Who completed graduates just now, they will comes under ASC, associate softwares. So your target is software engineer or senior software engineer as an experienced person. Okay.
So the promotion goes like upwards, like
TL, yeah, upwards. Correct. Based on your experience.
Experience,
they will promote to next levels.
Great.
So roles in Salesforce will tell us about your organization structure. So what user, so for example, project manager can see the data of project leader, whatever entered by the project leader, team lead, SSC, SC, AC, right? So like that, so your project manager can able to see this, the data of the downwards, whatever the team members are present, so that information they are able to see, right? So that comes under a roles part. We have, based on the requirements, we will create different roles. If you are building a sales team, so sales executive, senior sales executive, right? Senior sales executive manager. Like that we can build based on the requirement in the how they are giving. So based on that we have. Finally, what I'm telling, roles will decide just hierarchy or structure for whom you are reporting or anyone is reporting to you. If you have TL or PL position, so who is reporting to you, for whom you are reporting, this comes under a roles part. Then what about profiles here? So what profiles will decide? The profiles will decide about your work. It means what user can see. That means what application permissions you have. What tabs you are able to see, right? What tabs you are able to see. And what are all objects you have? Object permissions. And what fields you have? What fields I'm able to see? See, this everything profiles will tell about your permissions. This is just tells about your hierarchy for whom you are reporting. But here we can decide what applications user can see, what tabs, what objects, what fields, right? Everything will decide by your profiles and also administrative permissions. Any extra permissions if you want, that one also we will decide in the profiles only. Profiles is very, very important in Salesforce. Everything, most of the thing, 90% it will handle. The permissions related things it will handle. Everyone clear? What is the difference between profiles and roles? Definite question. What is the difference between profiles and roles? Can anyone tell me what you understood?
Roles will decide like hierarchical structure.
Any real time example?
Like jobs. Which position you are sitting in?
Okay. So if you go to office or anywhere, the companies, there, who is your reporting manager? That will decide by your role. If you joined as a senior software engineer, so who is your TL? Who is your PL? Right? That one decided by your roles.
Yes.
And profiles will decide, you have a software engineer profile, we will create one software engineer profile, we will give some permissions. Software engineer, what is required, what kind of applications, he can be able to see only his data, only his personal information. He cannot see others. He cannot see project leader, project manager data. Software engineer want only software engineers, his details only, his phone number, employee information, his salary details, only that permissions he is having. And any other applications he want, that application permissions we will give. You cannot give HR related information, HR applications to the software engineers. Whatever HR is using, that application permission you should not enable him. Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
As an admin, you should know what kind of permissions we have to give, what permissions we should not give it to the specific to roles. That is your duty. So profiles is very, very important. So we'll see both of concepts. First, just write down some about roles, how to create and steps, everything. After that, we'll go to profiles concept. First point, roles. Role in Salesforce role in Salesforce. The role in Salesforce tells about the structure or hierarchy. Structure or hierarchy of your organization. Organization data. Next point. Roles will tell to whom. To whom you have to report. To whom you have to have to report. Whom you have to report. And reports to you. Who reports to you? Who reports to you? Who reports to you? Next point, role will not give. Next point, role will not give. Role will not give any permissions. Any permissions. Can you write? It only says about. Only says about the hierarchy. It only says about the hierarchy. It only says about the hierarchy. Hierarchy. Next point. If two people have same role. If two people having same role, two people have same role, does not mean, does not mean does not mean they will get same permissions. They will get same permissions. If two people are having same role, software engineer or senior software engineer or team lead, two members having same role, that means they will not get the same permissions. Permissions may differ. Permissions may differ. That's my point. One team lead is having delete update access. Another team lead is not having that access. Like that also we can do. Like that also we can do by using profiles concept. Everyone clear?
Clear.
Right. To create roles, to create a roles, ask a question. Steps to create a roles, classic version. Classic version, I don't know. Administer. Setup administer. Manage users. Manage users. Roles. Add role. Add role. Add role. Lightning. lightning navigation. Administration, users, roles, add role. After click on add role in classic or lightning, wherever, some steps you have to follow here. Enter role name. Enter role label. Reports to role. Button. Click on save. Just connect to your developer console. File account, everyone. I will give some use cases. At least one or two you can implement now. So let me show how to create a role. Go to setup. First CM, don't write or don't do anything. Just to observe what I'm doing. I just clicked on setup. Force.com. Manage users. Under that we have a roles and profiles also here. Roles and profiles, same navigation. Here roles is available. Click on roles. This is what I was explaining. Executive staff under first, some example they given here. Territory based. So executive staff, vice president, hardware. This is one business unit. This is another business unit. This is another business unit. Just example purpose, the Salesforce is giving role hierarchy. The role hierarchy to control how your organization reports on the access data. You need to click on setup roles. Here we have organization name. This is your organization name. Starting while registering, we given self. Organization name self we given. If you are given any company name also fine. Under that first role is CEO. When you expand this one, CEO, who are all reporting? Vice President Sales, Human Resource, Senior Vice President Human Resource, Senior Vice President Customer, Service and Support, IT Sales. These are all reporting to whom? CEO. All reporting to CEO. This hierarchy given by your Salesforce. If you don't want this one, you can delete any point of time here. You can add your own hierarchy. Right? Based on our requirement, we can add it. So IT sales is there. If you expand this one, for example, nothing is there, roles. Senior Vice President, Customer, under that three roles they given. Customer Support International, North America, Prepaid Services. These are all roles. Who is reporting to what? What role? So here, we can see the roles in three formats. If you observe this drop down, this is also one of the questions people will ask usually. How many formats we can see? show in tree view, show in sorted list view, show in the list view. If I select tree view, anyway you are seeing now who is reporting what under whom. Let me select the second option, show in sorted list view. Show in sorted list view. Like this it will display sorted list. So here you are able to see properly who is reporting to whom. CEO. The channel sales team is reporting to director channel sales. COO reporting to directly CEO. Customer support international, this role is reporting to sales SVP, customer service support. This is what the sorted list view format. If you select third one, list view, some hierarchy it is showing. Like this it is displaying. The first one is comfortable, right? To understand properly who is under who. Which is comfortable, these three formats for you?
Preview
is first one. We can able to understand correctly here who is under what, right? So tree view is good.
Nice.
So just write down this point immediately. We can view the roles. We can view the roles. Roles in three formats. View the roles in three formats. Number one, review, sorted list view. Sorted list view, list view. Use cases we will do. First one. Add a new role. Role name is VP operations. Reports to IT sales. Add a new role, use case one, VP operations. The new role is reporting to whom? IT sales. IT sales is there or not, we have to check first. IT sales will directly report to CEO. IT sales is directly reporting to CEO. That is there or not, first we have to check. Writing part completed, everyone. Just confirm me, then I will go to application. Let me create this use case by me. Second use case onwards, you have to create and show me. So VP operations, IT sales already there, correct? IT sales is reporting to whom directly? IT sales is reporting to CEO. IT sales, we don't have any roles, right? Under IT sales, we don't have any roles. What I given use case? Which role I have to create? VP operations. See here, click on add role. Under that we have a button, right? Label name is VP operations. Role name, it is taking automatically. This role is reporting to whom? This role is reporting to IT sales. Role name as displayed in the reports. If you want how to show this role in the reports, if you are going to generate any reports, how you want. So this is not mandatory. Right now I am not giving. If you want, you can give same thing, VP operations. This is clear, everyone? This is clear?
Yes.
See, more than a minute, we can create one role. Less than a minute, right? Not more than a minute. I created one role. One role. This role is reporting to IT sales. So label is VP operations. Modified by, it is system fields. This is the system field. I didn't create this one. Right here, our role name is this one. Role name as displayed in the reports and sharing groups, roles and where this role is sharing, automatically is sharing to roles, roles and subordinates. Roles and subordinates. In that groups, it is sharing already, whatever you are creating new role. Then go back to roles. Click on setup roles. Under VP operations, IT sales, we have VP operations. This is clear, everyone? This is the first use case I implemented. Any questions here?
No.
Right. You can start implementing second one. I'll give. Second use case for roles. Add a new role. Add a new role. Name is manager. Reports to VP operations. Reports to VP operations. Create a VP operations. Let me take this one. Next use case also I will add in this. Because these two are interlinked, right? So first you create this one. First create this one. After that go to second one. Because it is interlinked with each other. First create first one, everyone. Whatever I created. I will give some other things also. By that time, I will write the notes. Add a new role. Name is manager. Reports to VP operations. Number four, new role. Name is reports to manager. Number five. Add a new role. Name is executive. Reports to five new roles I want from you people. Start implementing, everyone.
But here
IT sales already there. That one you utilize. Okay.
No, sir.
It's not showing, sir.
So we have to manually do it.
No. IT sales is not here, sir.
IT sales not there.
Not there, huh? Okay. Maybe I created in other classes.
Manually we can do it.
Okay, you can add it in the under CEO. You have to add him. Maybe I created in some other class. Okay. So you do one thing under CEO, create IT sales. So this is the first step you have to do, otherwise. Add a new role. Name is IT sales. IT sales CEO. This is the first step you have to follow. This is the first step. This is the second step you have to do. So I give an order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First role, you have to create IT sales, reporting to CEO. Second one, VP operations, reporting to IT sales. Someone is sharing the screen. Abhin, you are in mute.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Show me.
We created IT sales under CEO.
Okay. IT sales under CEO. 1 minute. Oh, correct. VP operations, HR manager.
The manager.
Clerk and field executive will report to manager only, right? Clerk and, let me cross check once. Clerk and field executives are reporting to manager, correct? HR manager and manager will report to VP operations, correct? That is correct. Right.
Excuse me, sir.
Share your screen and show me.
So can you able to see?
Yes. Okay. IT is reporting to CEO, perfect. VP operations under that manager. Manager, clerk, field executive reporting to manager, correct?
Finish, sir.
Quickly, others share and show me.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Uncle, can you see?
Yes. Right, IT sales under that VP operations.
Sure, man.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Fine. That is fine. Next. Rashad. Abdul. Nisana. Amarnath.
Sir, I can share, sir.
Yeah. Share.
Sir, I can't share. I can't.
You cannot share?
Yeah.
You are using mobile?
Mobile, but I will doing laptop, sir. My laptop is.
So who is sharing now? Marnath?
Sir, I'm sharing. Can you able to see my screen?
No. Can you try again?
Okay, sir. Sir, now? Are you able to see?
Yes. You go to application now. Right. Manager, clerk, field executives, HR manager. Yeah, perfect. Okay. Who is sharing now?
So can you share now?
Yes, sir. Abdul. Yeah, you can share them, Abdul.
Okay, sir.
Amarnath, you are sharing?
Yes, sir, I'm sharing.
Okay. Show me application.
Is it visible, sir?
Yeah, go to application. Yes.
Once.
Okay. Go to roles. I think in between Abdul is sharing.
One second, sir.
Okay.
Is it right, sir?
Manager. Yeah, perfect, Abdul.
Okay, thank you, sir.
But 1 minute, Abdul. You yes, added sir. SVP sales marketing.
Yes, sir. Before you telling that I am creating that sales.
Okay. You can restructure later. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Here, if you click on assign, IT sales is there, no? their assign button is there.
Yeah.
You can reassign to the CEO like that.
Here, in this,
you can restructure here. Using assign button, you can restructure. IT sales you have to do. IT sales. Now go back.
Now
go back. Go to previous thing.
Okay.
So IT sales is there, right?
Yeah.
Assign button is there. No? Assign button. Click on assign button.
This one, no?
No. Click on assign button.
Okay.
So here, available users, so search all assigned. Okay. So select that. Yeah, select that one. CEO.
Here.
Click on find button. Click on find button. Find, find.
This one, no?
Yeah.
Nothing come.
Not getting not, anything?
Not getting.
Okay. Users for IT sales. Okay. So here, from here, we can reassign. Otherwise, you can just add another structure in the under CEO. Okay.
Okay, new one now.
Otherwise, go back and there edit button is there. No, edit. You can do edit. Okay, go back. Click on setup roles.
This edit here, button is
there. Edit button. Click on that. From here, we can reassign the structure. This role is reporting to CEO. You select. Click on that.
And this one.
Search button is there. CEO. Okay. Save it. Save it now. Now see. It directly aligned to IT sales. Now it is aligned to IT sales.
Yeah.
IT sales is aligned to CEO, under CEO. Right. Perfect. Okay. Who is showing next? Right. You can stop sharing. Everyone completed? Anyone is pending? Vaishak not able to show. Abhin showed already. Elsida showed. Anyone is pending? So we will write some interview questions. Let me share my screen. So write down some questions here. If two roles, two users have, if two users have same roles, if two users have same roles, will they get same profiles? If two users have same roles, will they get same profiles? The answer is may or may not. May or may not. The roles are different. You can add profiles, may be different. You can assign different profiles. You can assign different profiles. Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Next point. Next question. If two users same role, two users have same role, will they report to same person? two users have same role, the two users having same role, will they report to same person? Not sure.
Yes.
Not sure, no? Or maybe. May not. Next one. If two users for same role, they report to same role. Two users having same role, will they report to same role? Is yes. Where can we create roles? That means environments. Environments, I'm asking. We can create roles in sandbox. Sandbox. Same thing you can deploy. Try to production, or directly you can create. We can create them directly on production. Directly in production also you can create. Directly on production also we can create.
One doubt here.
Yeah, tell me.
Question two and question three is one.
So two users have same roles, will they report to same person?
That means?
Persons may be different. Persons may be different. Person, I'm asking person. Person may be different.
Okay.
Here role they reports are same roles. Yes. Roles may be same. Maybe person is different, right?
Okay,
sir. Okay. Different business units.
Okay.
Just we will assign to one person.
Okay.
Profiles in Salesforce. Ready? Profiles in Salesforce. See, profiles, what it will control, as I told. It will control what kind of applications user can see, what objects, what fields, what tabs, what record types, user level permissions, page layouts. Everything is controlled by profiles. Everything is controlled by profiles. First point, right on. Profiles in Salesforce. Profiles in Salesforce. Controlled. Controlled. What user can access and what user can see the organization. The organization. What user can see in the organization. Second point, every profile is designed for a specific license. Every profile is designed for a specific license. Every profile is having one license. What license will tell? License will tell about your capacity. And profile will tell about your work, what you have to see in the application. License will tell your capacity. License will tell your capacity and profile will tell about your work. Your work. And what kind of things you can see. See, when you create any user in the Salesforce, we have to give one profile. We have to provide one profile. Every user will have only one profile. Every user will have only one profile. Your admin, Salesforce admin, is also one profile, right? Admin also having Salesforce license and profile. System administrator profile. Profile, what it will control. Profile controlled. Profile will control list of items you can write down. Which applications user can access? Which applications user can access? Which objects? First applications we will create. After that, we will create objects. This is the order, right? Which objects user can access? Field permission spelling. Just check them. Field level permissions. It will controlled by field level permissions. Tab permissions. It will controlled by tab permissions. Record types. We'll see what record types. All these things later. First, write down what it will control. Administrative permissions. Administrative permissions. User level permissions. User level permissions. Page layouts. Page layout permissions. Page layout permissions. See, in Salesforce, we have two types of profiles available. Two types of profiles. Number one, extended profiles. Standard profiles. Custom profiles. Standard profiles and custom profiles. See, what is standard, you know, right, already? What is standard applications? What is standard objects? What is standard fields? We saw so many things. What is standard profiles, no? Can anyone tell me?
Created by Salesforce.
Created by Salesforce. Given by the Salesforce. Examples also, one or two, you have to remember always. Standard profiles. Currently, people will ask in the interviews, or anywhere in the work, can you tell me some of the standard profiles in the system? First, write down, what is standard profiles? Profiles created by the Salesforce. is created by the Salesforce. To meet the global CRM requirements. Global CRM requirements. Global CRM requirements. Example. System administrator. Okay, one of the profile. Sales platform user. Sales platform user is one of the profile. Let me open the application. Some of the things we can write it. So the navigation is same. Setup, administer, manage users. We have a profiles. Navigation also I will give you. Don't worry. See here, system administrator. This is what I was telling, which is created by your Salesforce. Standard user, standard platform user, right? Analytics cloud integration user. Just write down one or two more. That is fine. Analytics cloud integration user. Analytics cloud integration user. Next, analytics cloud security user. Analytics cloud security user. Custom profiles. Side heading. Else. Custom profiles. See, what is custom profile, which is created by user to meet the organizational business requirement. Organizational business requirement. Write down. These are the profiles created by the user. These are the profiles created by the user. Commit is organizational requirements. Organizational business requirements. Okay. So we will see how to create a profiles. How to create a profiles in Salesforce. How to create a profiles in Salesforce. Every profile, we have to clone it. What is clone? What is mean by clone?
Duplicate copy.
As it is, one more copy you are creating. Clone. Cloning. Scientific word, right? Duplicate one you are creating. What Salesforce is doing, every profile you have to create from the existing profile. You cannot create a new profile. Got my point? Every profile you have to create from the existing profile only. You have to clone it. Standard profiles. We have standard profiles. From that, you have to clone. Right on one point. Every custom profile. Every custom profile created. Every custom profile is a clone of any one of the existing profile. Any one of the existing profile. Right. Steps to create custom profiles. To create a custom profiles. Navigation. Steps to create a custom profile. Set up, administer, manage users. Files. View profile. There are some steps here. Choose the existing profile. The license. Enter the profile name. Enter the custom profile name. It will create a new profile. You are selecting from the one of the profile. It will create a new profile. After that, you have to click on edit button. Edit button. Customize the permissions. Customize the permissions. View button. Lightning also, let me give him. application users, files, administration, users, profiles, new profile. Here also same navigation. Completed, just confirm me. Writing part completed. Writing part everyone completed?
Yes, sir.
So this is the first use case. Just write down first use cases. This is the second use case. License name is Salesforce platform. Copy existing from Salesforce platform user. Profile name is clerk profile. at these four, you have to create. Four profiles you have to create. These four profiles you have to create. Navigation, just I will show you. Writing part, everyone completed. Just confirm me. Anyway, I will send the screenshot. You can refer. Just confirm, you know, writing part complete. Just I will show in one profile how to create.
Sir, completed, sir.
Finished.
Right.
Okay, sir, completed.
With the navigation, go to setup, manage users. We have a profiles. So like this, profiles will load here. You need to click on new profile button. There are three things here: existing profile, user license, that profile name. New profile name we will give. You must select an existing profile to clone from. System administrator profile I will select. Existing profile is system administrator. Based on that, this will load. License will load. We cannot change that one. System administrator profile. What I will give? Manager profile I will create. So just this one I am creating here. You don't worry on that. System administrator profile selecting, and new profile I am creating, manager profile, correct? Just click on save button. I think yesterday I created already. Let me take another name, HR manager. HR manager I will take. HR manager profile is not required. HR manager I will give. Just click on save button. The profile is created. HR manager profile is created. Once profile is created, what are all sections you can observe here? Page layouts, field level permissions, field level security, which fields you can control. I told, right? Custom application settings, what applications user can see, you can control by using profiles. What tabs you can able to show to the user for this particular HR manager. Record type settings, right? How many things your profiles will control? Administrative permissions. Like for example, setup button you want to show or not. Setup button you want to show on. Like that, we have some permissions here. Still, how many things? General user permissions, standard object permissions, which objects you want to show, and read permission, create permission, edit permission, delete, view all, modify all. Once you create a profile, how many sections automatically it is showing? See, login hours, login IP ranges, enable Apex class access, right? So many things, sections it will create. Just go through this, all this. If you want to change any permissions, what we will do? Just click on edit button. Click on edit button. Here you can control the profiles. So if you want to show mutual fund applications to the HR manager, just a tick. If you want to, don't want to show, just remove it. Right? Like that, we can control everything here. They all in edit mode came. Which one you want to show, that permission you give here, remaining things you just remove it. See, view setup and configuration. View setup and configuration. Setup button you want to show, just show, otherwise you can remove this access. Everyone getting them? What is going on? See here, object level permissions. Accounts, object you want to show, with the read, create, edit, delete, view all, modify all permissions. How many checkboxes they are providing here? With these permissions, you can handle which even custom objects, invoice and loan payment project, four objects I created. So you want to show to this HR manager profile, read access, create access, edit access, everything you can control by using the profiles. That's why profiles is this much important in Salesforce. Everything you can control by using profiles. Everyone clear?
Yes.
So I have given other use cases. You just complete this use cases and show me in the tomorrow class.
Okay, sir.